that time for me last year. And through her ministry, that ministry established my calling for praying for people, and they got healed and they got totally delivered. I prayed for a certain man who came in our meeting that time. He was born with difficulties in hearing. He has never heard about it. He has never developed a healing for that year. And he got healed for the first time. He wondered what he gave me. He took from his pocket a gold watch. 2,000 he gave me, man of God. And he came. It is because of this woman. This woman of God entrusted me her ministry for prayer closet. And many people know that Pastor Kailo is our Kenyan pastor. And he has allowed all her leaders, all her finances, to be able to be praying with them. Woman of God, you met an eunuch. And I'm a eunuch. You know, an eunuch are the people who took care of the queen, of the king's wives. They were eunuch. Yeah, because they were entrusted that if I live with my wife, she's safe. So you trusted an eunuch. Thank you so much. And by doing that, she connected with her best friend, Mama Kari. Yeah. Now we carry her. This woman, she came for me in the airport for the first time and lost my bag. We were walking all over and all over. And because I lost my bag, she took me somewhere. She bought me new attires in order for me to preach. I'm a carrier of grace. My God, may He visit you in the name of Jesus. I was born with difficulties in talking. I was a special child. I was told I would never have children. And it decomposed my entire body. I was born as a special child. Really, really special child. I decomposed my entire body. I was born having problems in my speech. I was not able to speak, and I stammering, and what you call autism here. That's what I was suffering from. From there, I later developed a kidney failure. I later developed heart disorders, and that's why my body is like this. Even you can see, I'm a man who has been done some skin gravity in my manhood. I don't lie about it. That's a testimony for another day. And it was concluded, I will never have children. It was concluded, officially documented, my manhood ruptured, and I was done skin grafting. But today, I'm a father of 3 children. Father is God today. God healed me.
Amen.
One day I woke up and I realized that my sight had gone away. And I was blind for 6 good months, walking without seeing anything. And oh Jesus, God bless you so much for allowing me. Thank you, God, for my brother, we all came more than together to your wife, for driving me and for taking me to your pastor. God bless you so much. Without wasting much more time, if you can never manage time, you can never manage your life. It takes people who manages time to manage life. Thank you so much for Evangelist Shiro. Evangelist Shiro, she's a friend of my ministry and a friend of my family. Evangelist Shiro knows me. Over here, Evangelist Shiro, she's Evangelist Shiro. She came to minister with us, to be with us today. Evangelist Shiro, she's across. She has been to our church. She has been to my family. She's a friend of my family and a friend to my wife. And I told her that I'm around here. And today, out of her busy schedule, she decided to join me in the ministration of where I was ministering in the morning and where I am today. We are praying that Africa, Kenya will be well. We are praying that. Muniombe nisifungiwe huku. Naomba kama siku zinavutango kama blada. Ningevuta tu nijione niko Kenya. But God is good. So let me tell you, in this life, life is all about fighting. In this life, you were born as a fighter and you must live as a fighter. There's no free things. You never get things for free. You must fight for what you want. You don't wish to fight. You fight to win. You don't wish to fight. You fight to win. And this world will never give you what you want. I keep telling people, your battle began the day that you were conceived in your mother's womb. That's the moment your battle began. That's the moment your struggle began. And doctors, they keep telling us that before the fertilization of an egg, there are like 5 million of sperms. And all of those 5 million, they are fighting to come here on earth as a single egg. Am I communicating? Am I communicating? You can just imagine there were 5 million Samikayo like me, and all of them were fighting, telling each other, "Kama wewe ni mwanaume upite, na kama wewe sio mwanaume ukae ndani." And all of us were maktaini, wanaume mundu kumundu, wanaume milioni tano wanasema, "Mimi ndio nakuja duniani." Na wote wanataka kukuja duniani. But I fought out of 5 million sperms. I got fertilized. So I came here in this world as a fighter. I came here as a fighter. So you must learn to tell you, you must learn to know that you must continue fighting. That's what the Bible says. It is those who overcome shall make it to heaven. Heaven is not for losers. No. No, 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 no. It is those that shall overcome, that they will be given a new name and they will enter to heaven. So you better be a fighter. So fighting, that's what the Bible says, our warfare speaks about a perpetual war. It is our warfare are not carnal. And the Bible speaks about this man called David. And the Bible says that after David was anointed, the battle began, the struggle began. One thing that I've come to know, anointing will attract the battles. Anointing will attract the battles. If you want to be anointed, it is like saying, "I'm ready for war." Praise the Lord. Because you must know how to handle critics. You must learn how to fight. Because anointing will attract the battles. So when David has been anointed, number one, Saul have decided to terminate David. And David is not terminated. Let me tell you, David, he never prayed to become a king. He never asked. God make me a king. We pray for God to anoint us. We pray for breakthroughs. We pray for blessings. But there's no even single day that David prayed to become a king. It is God who chose him. So David, he has found himself in a battle without knowing. And the Bible says in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 23, 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse number 13, the Bible speaks about the struggle of David. The struggle of David, or David has been anointed, and the entire kingship, the entire army, they are looking for one boy. The entire army is looking for David. But the Bible says that when David is being sought by Saul, David was in the wilderness. He was in the wilderness. At the same time, God has given him a breakthrough in Hebron. But after getting breakthrough in Hebron, the Philistines has already come and they have already taken the fortune of David. Am I communicating?
Yeah.
So there's no any Canaan without the sons of anarchy. There's no next level without the Red Sea.
That's right.
And whenever there is Goliath, David must be there. And whenever there is the wall of Jericho, Joshua must be there. And whenever there is a Red Sea, Moses must be there. So the Bible says in verse number, the Bible speaks about the mighty men of David. Verse number 14, the Bible says, "And David was there in a hold, and the garrison of the Philistines was there in Bethlehem." So David, he's in a cave, and the garrisons of the Philistines was there in Bethlehem. What are they doing in Bethlehem? They have already taken what belongs to David. So they have already taken dominion from what belongs to David. So David, he has come out of Bethlehem. He has the cave. Because whatever belongs to him, it has been taken away. Someone say restoration. Someone say restoration. So David is already in the garrison, not because he has desired to be there, but because already the Philistines have taken what belongs to David. So that's what I'm telling you, that we need to keep on fighting. And the Bible says in verse 15, and David longed and said that, oh, that one would give me a drink of the water of the well of the Bethlehem, which is by the gate. So David, he has stayed in the cave and he has desired to have water. Remember the Bible says he will fulfill the desires of our heart. So I know everybody has a desire. Every family has a desire. Every nation have a desire. Every pastor have a desire. Everybody have a desire. It is our desire that projects us into prayer. You can never pray without a desire. That's what the Bible says. Whatsoever things you desire when you pray. So your desire will lead you into prayer. Your desire will lead you into seeking the face of God. So David, he has desired water in the well of Bethlehem. And the Bible says the Philistines are taking charge. Are taking charge. Now do you know what to tell us? Philistines is a spirit. The four brothers, the four brothers of Goliath are there. And they are guarding the well. They are guarding the well. And they are guarding the well not to provide security, but to make sure none of David's men has come over back. Am I communicating to somebody? So what I want you to know, I want you to pray for breakthrough. Someone say breakthrough. The opposite of breakthrough is struggle. What is breakthrough? Breakthrough, it is breaking and going through. It is breaking. You need a breakthrough. Already, there is a resistance. The word breakthrough, it is breaking here and going through. We are already in a closed facility. If we need to come out, we must access the door. If we do not have the door, we must break the wall and go through. Am I communicating? We must break the wall and go through because we cannot stay here. So David has desired water and he has said that, I desire that someone will give me water from the well of Bethlehem. I need that water. The water that the enemy has taken. I desire that water. I do not need water from Jordan. I need the same water in the well of Bethlehem. And the Bible says that after David had spoken, the Bible says that, and three men broke through. The Bible speaks, and three men broke through. These are the Abishai's. The Bible says, and three mighty men broke through the host of the Philistines, and drew water from the well of Bethlehem that was by the gate, and took it, and brought to David. Nevertheless, he will not drink therefore, but he poured unto the Lord. Someone say breakthrough. I know you need breakthrough in that business, but there is breaking. I know you need breakthrough in this land, but you must break. I know you need breakthrough from your generational curses, but you need to break. Let me tell you, the devil will never die. The Bible says, and God defeated, and Jesus defeated Satan. He never destroyed Satan. He never destroyed it. So the Bible says, power and authority has begun to run, has been given to us. So you need anointing to break through. Breakthrough is a spirit. Breakthrough is a spirit. I want you to know that. Because if you don't stop them, they will stop you. If you don't kill them, they will kill you. If you don't silence them, they will silence you. Let me tell you, there are some demonic altars in your family. Every night and day, they are speaking against you. But you need the anointing to break and to go through. If you don't break the altar of divorce, it will bring you down. If you don't break the altar of premature death, it will kill you. But I have come to declare, the anointing of breaking and going through has come upon your life. I want to declare, may the Lord punish the devil. The struggle is over. You are about to go to the next level. You are about to experience prosperity and success because you are breaking. Sema ninapenda. Fanya kidole na mwe. Ninapenda. Sema ninapenda. Sema ninapenda. Sema haleluya mama nego tuikania. Sema nego tuikania. Sema nitapenda. Ha nego tuikania. amesema nataka maji. Na kuna wale wanaume hawajabeba mikwaju, wamebeba mapanga. Kama wewe ni mwanaume kuja hapa. Kwenda imono shira hiyo tuko na mtu na kwani. Na the devil does not fear how anointed you are. If the devil even tried to conspire people to kill Jesus, are you Jesus not to be tempted? Wewe, oh shiko horana nawe. That's what the Bible says, yes, the God of this world. So that David desired water. Alitamani maji. Na hiyo maji, alisema nataka maji iliyo kwenye kisima cha Bethlehem. Nataka hiyo maji, sitaki ingine. You must learn to be specific the desire that you want. You must learn to be specific. But don't pray anyhow. Pray in a specific way. Bartimayo akasema, nataka kuona. Akataka upendo, akasema, naomba maji. Naomba maji. Naomba maji. Hakuna mtu hataki upendo. Hey, kila mtu anataka breakthrough. Unataka hiyo barua ipende ionekane. Unataka that permit. Unataka kuolewa na kuina mahoma kwa tukahika. You must break and go through. So today I want to tell God, anoint me for breakthrough. Hey, anoint me for breakthrough. Anoint me for breakthrough. I need breakthrough in my season. I refuse where I am. Lord, I need it now. I am tired of my life. I am tired of shame. I am tired of lack. I am tired of tears. I am tired of pain. Lord, I need my breakthrough. No more konoge kwa lelionia tu. Hana alichoka kasema kurutu wanyo na uwe kii. Onyo uwe kii. Wanuma. Alijokia mkiwa kia mwaka kwa mwabia. Ulipatia mtoto wa manikufe. Unegre mwaka na agui. Mana, you must be tired. Dawidi akasema nitaka hapa paka lini? Na kile kisima changu kimechukuliwa. Alipokuwa naongea, Roho Mungu akashukia wanaume watatu. Whatever is impossible, God will make it possible. We serve a mighty God. When you talk about a mighty God, He must do a mighty thing for Him to become a mighty God. And I want to declare, you are going to overcome. Receive your breakthrough. From today, your testimony has come. Your healing has come. Receive a new song. Today we are breaking. I break every curse. I break every curse. Every curse hanging in my life. Every curse hanging in my finances. Every curse. Emeleka kalababoya. I am anointed to break. I am anointed to break. Every curse hanging in my life. Every curse. Every limitation. Every pain. I'm breaking now. Madame, no, Ethio. Ndiye nataka kupenda. Utaishi kuchekelewa mpaka hata wewe unaweza ukachekelea wengine. Hata wewe unaweza ukasaidia wengine. Hai, kwani nini? Kwani nini? Unajua baraka bila kuwa na msuri. Usio mtu akua na upendo mpaka na ukikua na upendo mpaka unasikia tu. Unasikia kunaongezeka. Uwezi hata iwa gati ya gati tahika. Kumbe mimi kana yeye. Sema upendo. Sema upendo. Sema upendo. Sema unga utoreka ndio. Ugao shoka. Ugao tuwe kambia. Ugane go tuwe kambia. Ugane go tuwe kambia. Ugane go tuwe kambia. Waonge ama wasionge. Kupenya nijapenya. Mali na matia liye. Reparedi. Utuwe kambia uku. Maruwa maasi yato. Sema kuchapa. Uga kuhoda veru. Ora inenia yasi yato ginaiye naja. Dawidi akasema nataka mtu atakayenipatia maji. Na ndio jamaa sia wa jamaa wa Wafilisti wako pale. No kwa maji mara maji bausi. Dawidi na hali ya hinyirikeire. I wish mtu anipatie maji. Maana sema Mungu roho ikashukia wanaume watatu. Kaiwa matwini. Today I want to tell you, let God be a true God, and let every man be a liar. Amen. May the Lord ashamed your adversaries. Amen. May the Lord make a way where you seem to be going. I declare it is your turn. It is your turn. It is my family turn. It is my children turn. It is my turn now. your favor. My desire, oh Lord, it is to see my blessings. I declare it is my turn. Hata wafunge milango, bado nitapenya. Hata washikana mikono, bado nitapenya. Hata waongee mabaya yangu, nitapenya. Noko tuekania. Noko tuekania. Otuekania meshenea. Isaiah,
your family.
But here there are demons from the family. Moria, where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Ndio maana ukifika kamchupa kamchupa mpenzi mpenzi hivyo wanakufukuza. Unaona malaria. Yaani ni mtu si ate kitu authority. Eh kama ndugu yake kwa Daudi ni okay. Na ke Daudi haraka ni da hoya tuhe mai. Maji ni makilia. Mtu kama ngere maji. Daudi, I want to know this is a pastor and he desires breakthrough ministry. But there are some demons in Seattle. Do you know how many pastors came in Kenya and now they are back? I've given them stroke. I've given them all manner of demons. Ukijaribu kakanisa kanapasuliwa. But I want to tell you, our Living Grace Church International, the anointing of breakthrough, the anointing of breakthrough. For it is not by power, neither by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Season, either they like it or not, may the Lord punish the devil. May the Lord punish the devil, and that devil is a liar. Unajaribu anakufukuza. Ado matorago, meri la yeria. But I want to tell you, what we can do, what we can do. Let me tell you this: how many people died, but you are David of our days. You are receiving your breakthrough. Simama na miguu yako. You are receiving your breakthrough.
Father, we